Good morning, class 8 students. Welcome to your second session of biology on lesson 1, transporting plants. Last time you studied about the structure of conducting tissues in plants, xylem and phloem. And today we are going to move ahead. We will learn how xylem and phloem play a role in transporting water and minerals, especially xylem, since that tissue is concerned with the upward movement of water and minerals as well as absorption of water and minerals from the soil. Now, this process takes place with the help of three steps. The first step is absorption by root hairs. Now, what are root hairs? If you have ever seen seeds germinating, you will find that the tiny seedling has a main root and many tiny hair-like structures going out. These hair-like structures are called as root hair. One root hair I have drawn in detail over here. This root hair, you can see, is like an ordinary plant cell. The root hair bulging out. This is one cell. It has cell wall, cell membrane, vacuole and nucleus. But the important thing which we need to pay attention is if the cell saponate is concentrated, means it has less water. So, since it has less water, it has the capacity to absorb more water from the soil, surrounding soil. This is done by the three processes of osmosis, diffusion and active transpose. Osmosis means the movement of water molecules from their high concentration in the soil to their low concentration inside the root here. This is inward movement of water molecules by the presence of semi-permeable membrane, that is cell membrane. Osmosis takes place through cell membrane by the root here. The second process which takes place is diffusion. Some water also moves in the root here by diffusion, that is movement of water molecules from their high concentration in the soil to their lower concentration inside the root here. This doesn't need the presence of cell membrane. Cell wall can also help in it. Then the third process which helps in absorption by root hairs is active transport. This active transport needs energy because this is absorption of minerals, both organic and inorganic. Certain minerals are needed by plants. So they are already in high amount inside the root hair, but more are absorbed from the soil for maintaining plant health. This is done against the concentration gradient, that is from lower concentration to higher concentration. So this needs energy, and that is why the name active transport, because here energy is consumed by the root hair cells to take in minerals. Then the second, after the root hair cells have absorbed water, the second step comes in, that is cell to cell transport of water. So, cell to cell from root cortex till up till the xylem vessels, water is moved by the process of osmosis, diffusion and active transport. And lastly, the third step is involved, that is ascent of cell, which involves two processes, root pressure and transpiration. Ascent of sap starts from the xylem vessels in the stem and it continues up till the xylem vessels in the leaf. So here in this root pressure, the roots have gorged in water. There are lots of water and this creates pressure on the xylem vessels. You may have seen a balloon filled with water, and when the balloon is almost up to its limit of filling up of water, after that it explodes. So right now the root pressure has built up due to root cells being absorbed water up to their limit. And since they are now at the point of explosion, they move this water up into the xylem vessels. The second thing which also causes ascent of sap, that is movement of cell sap. Now the liquid inside the vacuoles of cell is cell sap. So this ascent of sap is also done with the help of transpiration. Transpiration is the loss of water, excess water as water vapor through stomata. When the plant leaves lose water, they have lack of water, and to satisfy their lack of water, they ask the stem, the xylem vessels and the leaf xylem vessels to satisfy or fulfill their need of water. So this way an enquiry is sent, need is sent to the xylem vessels and to the root and root hairs to absorb more water. So ascent of sap takes place due to root pressure in the root cortex cells and due to transpiration pull created by loss of water in the leaf. You must know more about this in a video that will follow.
Transportation of water and minerals in plants. Like animals, plants also have a mechanism of transportation of mineral solution. This takes place through a system called vascular system. In plants, vascular system consists of two types of conducting tissues. Xylem. Xylem consists of mainly thick and tubular cells forming a pipe-like structure. It conducts water and minerals from the ground to the stems and leaves. Phloem. These are long, thin tubular structures placed one above the other. It conducts food produced in the leaves to the stems, roots, storage parts and reproductive organs. The movement of food substances from the region of synthesis to the region of utilization is called translocation. Thus, during transportation, three processes are involved. 1. Absorption of water and mineral solution. 2. Rise of cell sap. Ascent of sap. 3. Translocation of food material. Absorption of water and minerals. Plants absorb water and mineral salts from the soil with the help of their roots. The solution of water and mineral salts is termed as capillary water and present between the soil particles called pore spaces. Along with water, mineral salts also enter the roots of the plant by the process of osmosis, diffusion and active transport. 1. Osmosis. It involves the movement of solvent molecules, water, from a region of their higher concentration to a region of their lower concentration through a semi-permeable membrane. In root hair cell, the cell sap is more concentrated than the surrounding capillary water. Thus, water moves into the root hair cell by the process of osmosis. 2. Diffusion. It involves the movement of any molecules, solid, liquid or gas, from the region of higher concentration to the region of lower concentration. 3. Active transport. It involves the movement of substances from a less concentrated region by utilizing energy in the form of ATP. Mineral salts are absorbed by the roots through active transport. Rise of cell sap, ascent of sap. In plants, it is an important feature to carry out vital activities which occur through xylem and phloem. Water is absorbed through the roots and conducted to other parts of the plant where it is used for various purposes. The minerals in the form of water solution are also absorbed by the xylem from the soil. Thus, xylem acts as a pipeline for conducting water. The water and mineral solution that is absorbed by the roots and are conducted upwards to the stems, leaves, flowers and other parts of the plant is called ascent or rise of cell sap. Translocation of food material. The prepared food material reaches from leaf to different plant organ is called translocation of food material. It is known that phloem cells are involved in the transport of soluble food material from leaves to different plant organs. This movement of food from the phloem cells is bidirectional, that is, food can move up and downwards simultaneously. Activity: to show the upward movement of water in plants. Method: take a fresh potted plant of tomato. Cut its shoot near the soil. Fix a glass tube and tighten the connection with a rubber band. Add water in the tube so that the cut surface does not dry up. Add 2 or 3 drops of oil to prevent evaporation. Add water in the pot and see to the level of water rising up. This is due to root pressure caused by absorption of water. Result: the level of water rises up due to root pressure caused by the absorption of water. This shows the upward movement of water. Activity: to prove that translocation of food material occurs through phloem. Method: in a woody stem, all the outer parts, that is, phloem, is removed in the form of ring or girdle. This includes phloem along with the bark. It is kept moist by keeping wet cloth around the ring. After 2 to 3 days, a swelling is observed just above the ring. This portion of stem swells up due to the accumulation of food material in the tissues. This is because the prepared food by the leaves does not reach below the ring due to removal of phloem. Result: this proves that phloem is essential for the translocation of food material. Transpiration: plants absorb a large amount of water from the soil, but the plants do not consume the entire water. Only 2 to 5% of the total absorbed water is utilized by the plants. Rest of the water is lost from the aerial parts of the plants in the form of water vapor. Thus, the process in which excess water is lost from the leaves in the form of water vapor is called transpiration. Activity: to show that transpiration occurs through leaves. Method: take a well-watered potted plant on a glass plate and cover it by a dry bell jar. The apparatus is made airtight through Vaseline. After some time, the bell jar becomes misty and a few small droplets will also be seen on the inner surface of the bell jar. Result: this shows water vapor formed during transpiration has condensed on the inner surface of the bell jar in the form of droplets.
Students, the video was quite informative, isn't it? Now there is a worksheet to be solved by you. Stay home. Bye.